We're about to hear a story that has been told and retold for 2,000 years. The Nativity reveals something very special about God, that he was prepared to be with us and live among us through his son, Jesus. This story opens with a young woman in her home named Mary. Unless you look a bit deeper, there is nothing remarkable about Mary. She was from a town called Nazareth and engaged to be married to Joseph. But to God, she was very important. She was so important that God sent an angel down from heaven with a message for her.
Do not be afraid. I am the angel Gabriel. I bring good news. The Holy Spirit will come and its power will bring you a baby boy. People will call him the Son of God. You will name him Jesus.
This was surprising news to Mary and Joseph. They weren't expecting a baby yet, but they trusted God's plan and they were excited to be a part of it. Several months later, the townspeople had been hearing a decree that Caesar Augustus was going to make. They had gathered in the town square to hear what was going to be said.
Hear ye, hear ye! Caesar Augustus declares that there will be a census. Everybody will be counted and must return to their hometowns. Now all of you go back to your homes and prepare for your trips. Leave as soon as you can.
Joseph's hometown was a place called Bethlehem, so they traveled a long way with Mary riding on a donkey's back. They reached Bethlehem. They knew they needed to find a place to stay soon, as it was getting close to time for Mary to give birth. They started knocking at the inn doors.
Well, let's head to Bethlehem.
Hey,
We made it to Bethlehem.
I am very sorry, but there's no room here. Try next door.
Hello, I don't have any more room here. I'm sorry, but we don't have any more room left. Good luck.
We don't have any more rooms available, but you shouldn't be traveling out this late. We have a stable in the back where you can stay. There will be a roof over your head, and the animals are nice. They will not bother you.
Joseph worked quickly to make Mary a comfortable bed. He knew this was not the ideal place to bring baby Jesus into the world, but he felt at peace. This is how it was meant to be. Shepherds were tending their flocks at night when an angel appeared right before them. They were all so surprised when they saw the angel and she spoke to them. You see, these shepherds are just ordinary people, going about their daily lives. They weren't considered very important. Nobody took much notice of them.
Behold, we bring good news of great joy, good news for the people across the world. Today in Bethlehem, a baby is born for you, a Savior who is Christ the Lord. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger.
Glory to God in the highest heavens, and peace to his people on earth.
This is surprising, but must be true.
Let's go see the baby.
Sometime later, three important people went to visit Jesus. These people are sometimes called kings or wise men, but they were actually magi.
That's the same word that we use when we say magic.
These were very clever people who knew all the secrets of the stars. They knew from examining the heavens that an important event was taking place. A bright star rose in the sky.
We must follow the star. We need to worship this baby who has been born.
but they didn't find him there. They saw the bright star ahead of them again and followed it until it stopped. The wise men saw the child and they worshipped him. Each of them brought a special gift to bring to the baby Jesus.
Because you are the King of Kings, we bring you gold.
Because you are the Son of God, we bring you frankincense. And because you are the Savior of the world, we bring you myrrh.
So that is the story of the Nativity and how average people like you and me became extraordinary with God's intervention and the birth of our Savior Jesus.
The end!
'You shall not pass!